want you to put your hand on your neighbor and tell them you don't need a cure, because we have the healer. I don't care if it's HIV. It doesn't matter if it's AIDS. We don't need a cure. Somebody shout, the healer is here. Come on, let me hear your church shout it. The healer is here. Put your hand on your neighbor and tell them the healer is here. Just flood this room with that. He's here. Say it. The healer is here. He's here. The healer is here. He's here. I'm expecting tumors to disappear, cause the healer is here. I'm expecting your bloodstream to come back to its original form, cause the healer is here. Somebody get your hands up, say, he's here. Jesus, how many, is this the last song? We got one more song? This the last song, right? This the last song? This the last song? He's here.
He's here.
The healer is here.
The healer is here.
Whew.
He's here.
Say, the healer is here.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Restoring Health Ministries. We are so excited to have you here. Thank you, and thank you for joining us, you, and whoever is going to watch the replay. Come on, let's get in some praise and worship today. Come on, the song that says, our God is greater. Our God is stronger. He is higher than any other. There's nobody like our God. Hallelujah. If you know the song, come along and sing with me, whether you're in your car, your house, your bed. Come on, open up your mouth and give God praise today. Water, you turned into wine. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. None like you. Into the darkness we shine. Out of the ashes you rise. There's no one like you. None like you. Come on, come on. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power, our God, our God, oh, our God, he's greater, our God is stronger, hallelujah. Into the darkness we shine, out of the ashes we rise, There's no one like you. Oh, no one, Lord, none like you. Hallelujah, we sing. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, yes, He is. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, yes, He is our God. Oh, if God is for us, who can be against us? No one, nowhere. Hallelujah. Come on, sing with me. If God, and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then nothing stands against. And if our God is for us, then who can stand and stop us? And if our God is with us, then we can stand against. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? If He's for us, who can ever stop us? Oh, and what can stand? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? Oh, yeah. What can stand against? Then what could stand against? No one can stand against us. Oh, sing our God. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is greater, stronger, higher than any other God. Hallelujah. And we give you praise and honor, God, for you are our God. Hallelujah. His song says, our God is stronger. Our God is greater. Anybody can talk about their God. You can talk about your God all you want to. But I know that my God is greater. He's greater than any other. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Once again, welcome to Restoring Health Ministries, where we are restoring health with the word of God. We are so glad that you are here today. Thank you for joining us this afternoon. Thank you. And we're just going to open up with some prayer, and we are going to give God the glory. Father God, thank you for all that you are. Thank you for all that you've done for us. We give your name the praise and the glory. We thank you for waking us up today. We thank you for having breath in our bodies. We thank you that everybody is gathered here today to listen to a powerful word for our speaker tonight. Bless him right now, Lord God, as he opens his mouth to minister a word to the people of God. We thank you, though. Those who have an ear, let them hear what the word of God is saying today. And so we give your name all the praise. We come against every distraction right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for all technical issues being behind us. We thank you right now. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen. Amen. So let's start with our announcements. We are just going to we have some announcements that we are here. Our sister Tanya was feeling a little bit under the weather. And so we said, I got you, girl. We are going to take these announcements for you. And here we go. Amen. So welcome to Restoring Health Ministries. Here are our announcements. Our scripture reading is going to be 3 John chapter 2. Beloved, I wish all above all things that thou mayest prosper so that, I'm sorry, I'm not used to doing announcements, y'all. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prosperous. And I know I just did that all kinds of backwards, but that's okay. June is Men's Health Month, and Restoring Health Ministry wants to use our platform to share education and awareness about men's health issues around the world and to encourage men that our Lord will and can restore health. RHN today is also Communion Sunday. So I hope you have all your communion, all your elements for Communion Sunday. If you would like to be a blessing, if you would like to be a blessing to RHM, just cash at us at $RHM3017. That's $RHM3017. Our upcoming event, set your reminders. Join us on Wednesday for Bible study, for healing Bible study. You can watch healing Bible study on our YouTube page. We are preparing for our July's 30-day challenge. Join us. There will be no Christina Nelson show on this Tuesday at 8 p.m. You can watch all previous episodes on the Christina Nelson Show YouTube or Facebook page. As I said, the month of June is Men's Health Month. Restoring Health Ministry supports Men's Health Month. Our goal is to see your mental, physical, and spiritual health restored. Ladies can join us as well. Next Sunday, Pastor Eric will be our speaker. When you're diagnosed with an incurable disease, such as multiple sclerosis, etc., it can be very frustrating because you either can't travel, are bedridden, can't afford to travel because you're on disability, or you don't have anyone to take you. Well, Pastors Eric and Christina have found ways to go by being in the comfort of your own home. RHM family, we want you to meet us in Vegas for a night of fun. That's virtually. This will give you time to fellowship, fun prizes, and win fun prizes and more. We all will be staying at the Bellagio. That's right, the Bellagio. Let's create memories. Reach out to Pastor Eric if you would like to attend. Y'all, this is virtual, so don't get all uptight and saying, oh my God, we're going to Vegas. What have they done? This is a virtual event, and they have many things to do in Vegas other than what you think. Join our July 30th Restoring Health Challenge. According to Jeremiah 30:17, he restores your health. Register today by email at restoringhealthmin@gmail.com. Type challenge accepted. That is email restoringhealthmin@gmail.com. If you ever have an announcement you want us to read, send it to Pastor and First Lady for approval. And if approved, they will add it to the Sunday announcements. Thank you. Happy birthday, all June babies. Happy birthday, all the June babies. All right, now you can follow Restoring Health Ministry on Threads, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. This concludes our announcements, and I already read the scripture earlier today. So now let's get us restored with Charlena's beautiful dance of Healing Ministries, Healing Dance Ministries.
Praise the Lord, everybody. If you've been restored, come on, give God a word, a worthy praise. He is worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, his name is to be praised. Father, we just thank you for this day. We thank you. We love you. We honor you. We magnify you. We glorify you. We give your name all the praise, all the honor. We thank you, Lord God, for this day, for this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. God is worthy. Come on, I want you to do something for me. I want you to put in the comments, I have been restored. I have been restored. I have been restored. That when you look up the word restored, that word restored or restoration is to bring back, bring something back to its original state. And God wants to bring your health back to its original state. We have people that have been diagnosed with all types of conditions that are on here today, and we believe that you have been restored. For the Bible says that I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds. Not saith Eric, but saith the Lord. God said it. If we believe that God said it, we believe that God will do it. And there's another translation. I believe it's the Living Bible translation, where it says that I will bring back your health. And I believe that there may be somebody that may be on here today that may be dealing with some health issues. You may be dealing with some issues with your mental state, or no matter what you're going through, I have physical illness. God can restore. The word, I believe God's word. I believe it's true. If God said it, I believe it's going to come to pass. I believe that no weapon that is formed against us shall be able to prosper. God is good, and he is greatly to be praised. I want to thank you all for being on here today. God bless you all. I see my mom is on. We have Doris Stanley that's on, Sheila that's on here today. I saw Charlena. I see Sister Tanya. We continue to pray for you. That's on. I believe Bishop Jonathan is on. And whoever else is on, I can't see you. Pastor Christina is on. God bless you all. I want to welcome all our visitors, our first time visitors, those that never been on with us today. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You can also post if you are on YouTube. I'm going to tell you, I'm going to walk you how to get to it. If you go onto YouTube, all you have to do is look for, I believe it just says comments, and you just hit on that, and you begin to, I see my sis here. God bless you, Keisha. Praise God, sending love to the family. God bless you. God bless you. God bless all of you all. I love you guys, and I pray that you all are having a marvelous, marvelous day. You know, I was sitting back, and I was listening to praise and worship, and I was listening to Pastor Christina sing, and she sang today, y'all. And I was just sitting back, just listening and just reflecting. I always do this reflecting thing when my brothers come on, and I was just reflecting, you know, looking, because I can see my brother backstage, but I don't know if he can see me, but I can see him. And you know, I was just doing this reflecting thing, and I was just thanking God, because you know, I just wish my dad was here to be able to experience this. You know, he would be so proud of us. You know, I remember, we no matter where we went, It could have been the grocery store. These are my three sons. All three of them in ministry. I could see him and he'd be so excited, you know, about that. And he didn't have a problem with telling people about the goodness of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we thank you for that. And God bless my mom too, who prayed for us and her sacrifice for us, you know, growing up in Washington, D.C. And we thank and praise God for my mother and all my other family members who may be on. If you're on, God bless Pastor Ray. God bless Ray Nelly. God bless Kim. God bless. We truly thank and praise God for you all. But I'm going to move out your way at this time. And now I am going to just introduce to you my youngest brother, guys. I'm the shortest out of the bunch, but yeah, but I'm the oldest, but I'm the shortest. And but I truly thank and praise God for my brother Cleveland, who went off to Bible college some years ago, came back, and God called him into ministry. Laquanda, God bless you. And gotten married, and had a few kids, and he gave blessings with some nieces and nephews, and God bless the family, and just love my family to pieces. And so anyway, let me move out you guys' way, and I'm gonna allow my brother to take over and allow the Lord to use him and have his way. Restore Health Ministries, let's open up and welcome Youth Pastor Minister Cleveland Nelson III.
Good afternoon, everyone, wherever you are in the country. I hope everyone can hear me and hear me. Let me turn myself up a little bit. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon from Maryland, and or Maryland, as we say. It's the A in there, but it's the er. You gotta have the er. So we're here in Maryland, and just thank y'all. Just wanted to thank my brothers, my sister Christina, Pastor Christina, Pastor Eric, for this opportunity. I just wanted to say that I'm proud of you, because most people could have a diagnosis and they could waddle in it, but you decided to do something that would not just help yourself but help others. And so for that, I'm proud of you, and proud of you both. And so I love you. I won't do too much talking. I do want to give a shout out to, I can't really see who's on, but you did say my mom is on. So hey, mom, my wife, children who should be taking a nap right now, but I know they can hear everything we're saying, because someone just said bless you. So someone is not asleep. And so I wanted to give a shout out to them. My home church of Community of Hope, where Reverend Pastor Tony Lee is pastor, here in Suitland, Maryland. So I just want to go before, I won't be for you long. I just want to say a quick prayer. First, let me read the scripture, and then I'm going to give you my title, and then we'll get on from there. The scripture is Romans 2:12, with the emphasis on the very first part. Do not, that is Romans 2:12, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. And with the emphasis on the very first part, though, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. With this being Men's Health Month, I'll just add Men's Mental Health Month as well. My title is Having a Renewed Mind While Dealing with Generational Trauma. Let us pray. Dear Lord, hook it up. In your name we pray. Amen. And so with this being Men's Mental Health Awareness Month, or Men's Health Awareness Month, I challenge each of you to have a seat. I challenge each of you to have a seat on my couch, because this is not a therapy session. And my heavenly ordained purpose for being here this afternoon is for the subject matter that is for us men. Us men may not always have the platform to do so, but that's right, my sisters. I said it's for us men, but now, ladies, this does not mean that I'm not talking to you, but I want to speak directly to my brothers. And in the process of doing that, I want to help my sisters to understand us brothers just a little bit more. You see, mental health is viewed these days as a cool thing to say. It's cliche-ish. Everyone says it. You see it on commercials. We have corporations and jobs using the language that it's all about mental health. But we have jobs that are talking about mental health, but never truly give the respect and employees for the mental health. We have jobs that don't realize that while they're talking about mental health, they're very reasons that we have mental, they're the very reason why we have a lot of our mental health issues, if we're honest. Those very same very jobs. See, this is a catchy thing to say, and I am working on my mental. I'm getting myself together. And at the same time, a lot of us brothers never really check on it ourselves or take it serious. A lot of us suppress how we feel, and this suppression goes back to when we were kids, when we were told not to be soft and to suck it up and to stop being weak, stop whining, stop crying. You better not cry. Stop acting like a girl. Stop acting like all of these other terms that are not occurring, nor are they politically correct even to say in the first place. Can I just be real with you this Sunday afternoon? But if we take a second and go further, our suppression and our trauma goes way back. You see, it goes way back to when those slave ships left Africa. That trauma of being on a ship and stacked on top of other bodies, on them and some of them on you. And most of them dead for weeks as you traveled across the water. Most of them sick. Now just imagine yourself just on a ship and someone is vomiting and they're on top of you and there's nothing you can do. This, imagine someone just losing bodily fluids and they're just on top of you. The smell, the stench. Most of them were sick. You were stripped from your family, and now you come to a new land. And in this new land, you find yourself a new wife because your old wife was left in Africa. You have been forced to watch someone rape your wife. Maybe they was raping the men, trying to castrate them. You saw that. Imagine that being that boy that it is happening to his dad. And now he grows up and the slavery is going on for generations. And his own sons are now finally free. And is he? Because he now watches his brother get hung by the Ku Klux Klan. The civil rights era happens. And now grandchildren are being called the N-word, trying to integrate schools. And his son goes on to be shot at a Panther rally. See, then crack hits the scene, and our fathers get addicted, and our homes and our communities are now devastated and destroyed. And we grow up and we watch all of our friends die because of the war on drugs. This generational trauma is all connected. And as we ask men, why are you so quiet, and why are you so tired, and why are you drinking so much, and why are you sleeping around, and why are you betting on games so much, and why are you looking at porn? Well, let me tell you why. It's because my mind is a mess and I'm carrying generations of trauma, and nobody has been healed. Dr. Joy DeGroe, author of the book Post-Traumatic Slave Syndrome, speaks on this multi-generational trauma. She goes to say that if a people group face an oppression for years, wars and famines, it would have a mental and an emotional impact. Meaning you ain't even have to be alive to be affected by what your great, 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 great grandparents went through. You're just being in the lineage, just being added more members to the family does not take away the pain. It doesn't take away the hurt. Papa was a Rolling Stone because his daddy was a Rolling Stone. His daddy was a Rolling Stone because his daddy was sold to another family of slave owners, and nobody has seen him since. And see, when they tell you to remember the Holocaust and to never forget 9/11, but when it comes to slavery in America, you are told to just get over it. But when they tell you that, just tell them, I cannot, because this traumatic generational oppression is in my lineage. There's a couple of areas that I want to talk to you about this afternoon, and hopefully these areas can help you to find your own healing, your own peace. See, the scripture speaks of a renewed mind, the renewal of a mind. And according to BibleStudiesTools.com, the renewing of your mind, according to Romans 12:2, means interpreting the life, that means the lens of God and the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, rather through the lens of your experience, woundedness, trauma, preferences, and others' opinions and others. It's a fundamental shift towards seeing the world, yourself, others, God, and especially what people with possibles from the kingdom perspective. It's making a daily, moment-by-moment choice to choose the mind of Christ, which lives inside of us as new creations, rather than operating from the soulish mind the way we did before we were saved. But see, to be a new creation speaks to being healed from being an old creation. You see, it's not a matter literally of being created again. Rather, it is God healing us from the inside so that others can see the results on the outside. This Paul was the one who was chained on that old dusty road, writing here, having a renewed mind. This is Paul who faced his own trauma. This is Paul who was beaten, and Paul who was harassed, Paul who was thrown in jail, Paul who was unjustly thrown in jail, Paul who was stoned. And that Paul, we see, faced his own trauma, and now is speaking of a healing because he knows the power of healing. God has healed his heart, and God took the scales off of his eyes, and now he knows that the only way he can receive his healing is through Christ. That's the only way he can receive his healing. But we have our healing, but we have some ways that we can find the healing. The first one is prayer. The first one is prayer. One way that we can heal is the art of prayer. Prayer can help any issue that we are facing. Prayer is our communication between us and God. Prayer allows us to be vulnerable, allows us to express the way we feel. We can express what we are thinking or what's troubling our heart. You see, sometimes the trauma that we face will allow for us to conform to the things of this world. It'll make us go to our old vices or even new vices. But Paul is here and he's telling us not to conform by the patterns of this world. Do not conform, but be transformed. And how else would you be transformed else but just by prayer? Growing up here in DC, I've seen a lot. I've dealt with so much trauma, and I kept it inside. Even things that no one may not even know about or know that I've seen or envisioned, but under the guise of you have to be strong. Growing up in a house, and I saw things that still haunt me to this day, talking to friends and dapping them up only for them to be murdered days later, seeing dead bodies in front in the front yard of people who overdosed on the street and trauma, dodging your own bullets and just trying to head to the corner store or out of the party, trauma. But it was when my daughter was born that I battled a depression and things that I didn't even know that I was going through, a postpartum, something that is known to women that go through at times. But this was something that I found out that men go through as well. But I want you to know that healing can happen. And I want you to know that healing will happen. And I am here to tell you that prayer must happen. But as much as I tell you about prayer, I want you to know that I'm not just telling you what I was told growing up. It's just that we just got to pray everything away. We got to pray the poverty away. We got to pray the pain away. We got to pray that trauma away. We got to pray the addiction away. We got to pray this away and that away. But you cannot just do that and do that alone. No, no, no. You need to go to therapy. And people used to struggle because you not praying enough. They say you're struggling because you're not praying enough. You're struggling because you have this generational trauma and you need help. You see, prayer plus therapy, it's like peanut butter and jelly. It's like the faith plus the works. It's the problem. If you have a problem with your skin, you go to a dermatologist. If you have a problem with your mouth, you go to a dentist. If you have a hair issue, you go to a stylist. When it comes to your mind, why is it so taboo to see a therapist? When it comes to your mind, we're supposed to just pray everything away? But I remember when I was in Ghana and at the slave castles, and I went to one and it was so emotional, but it was the last castle that I went to and I could still smell the enslaved Africans. You can literally smell the blood and the body fluids and everything that was trapped in the stone of the castle. I could still smell the trauma. I could still smell the anxiety. I could still smell the fear. I can still smell the rape and the beatings. And I could still see the literal fingerprints and claws in the walls where people were trying to get their way out. I can see the scripture of the wall, which means that's right above the room where they were actually raping the women, just below, in the room where they were trying to convert them over. But when I look over at a sign, I saw something that said, "In honor of those who refuse to die." Well, let me tell you that no matter what trauma that you've been through in your family, you are the ones who refuse to die. And they gave me a name of Yao Abwabweo, which means you are the one who has returned. But you ain't even heard what I said. I said trauma can't kill you. And because you refuse to die, that trauma ain't destroyed you, because what God wanted to do in your great, 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 great grandfather is going to continue to happen until God can do what God wants to do through you. And God will finally, your family will find that healing. And let me tell you, because it's not just about me being the Abwabweo, the one who they want to return. It's the one who will return. It's because one glorious morning when Jesus cracks the sky and takes the place to where there's no more wars and no more drama, there's no more pain and no more mental health issues and no more suicidal thoughts and no more anxiety and no more depression and no more multiple sclerosis and no more cancer and no more diabetes and no more just nothing. God will be here. And in the name of Jesus, you will be healed. You will be healed. You will be able to run again. You'll be able to walk again. You'll have your new legs and a new body. You have a new mind. God is real. And I want you to know today that God is transforming your mind, taking away all of the generational pain and anguish and trauma that we have dealt with in our lives. There's a reason why Daddy was hitting people, because somebody he saw was hitting somebody. There's a reason why people was cursing people out, because that's what they saw happen to them. And God is going to touch that generational, and God is going to break that generational hold that's on your family today in the name of Jesus. And what God wanted to do through your family, God is going to do it through you. And it's going to happen with the Bible. It's going to happen with therapy, and you're going to find your healing. Amen.
Amen, amen, man. What a word, what a word. What a word. God is so good. He is so amazing. We, you know, I admire you for sharing this word today. A lot of people don't realize the power of trauma and how trauma affects a person. And it's almost like it affects your insides. And so almost like it kind of grows with you, and if you don't, you know, seek out the help and to be able to have people that are in your life to be able to share, and people in your life that you can trust, and people in your life that you can go to. I remember when I used to go to Jabbok, I remember one of the things that Bishop Wright used to say, that we need to have what we call go-through buddies, people that we can go through with, people that while I'm going through, I can trust you while I'm going through this storm in life. Because sometimes people are going through, not sometimes, but there are people that are going through every single day, and they don't have a buddy, a go-through buddy, to be able to share, you know, what they're experiencing, what, you know, what's on their mind, how they feeling today. They, you know, if they're up, they're up. They're down, they're down. They're cold or they're hot. You know, they just don't have that person to be able to share. And when you're diagnosed with that, with an incurable disease, just like the woman with the issue of blood, you know, according to the law, she couldn't stand outside. She couldn't be inside with her family. And so I can imagine how that may have felt. And so she had to stay outside in the backyard, and she had to stay outside and Christmas, and she missing birthdays and anniversaries and family gatherings and missing all those different types of things. Mentally, we can, you know, you can imagine what she may have experienced with that diagnosis, with the issue in her blood. I don't know what your issue is today, those that are listening. Maybe your issue is mental health. Maybe your issue is multiple sclerosis. Maybe your issue is fibromyalgia. Maybe your issue is arthritis or cancer or lupus or whatever your issue is. Maybe you're not sick. Maybe you may be dealing with some things mentally. Maybe you're dealing with some things, you know, physically. And so we believe in Restoring Health Ministries that God wants to restore your health. God wants to renew your minds. He says, be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and the perfect will of God. God wants to renew. God wants to restore your health. Man, what a word. God bless you, bro C. And hey man, I want to ask you, what's your, you have a Cash App? We want to be able to be a blessing into your life. Yeah. And we want to sow into your life, sow into your ministry. What's your Cash App?
I know my wife is listening, so Keisha, okay, if she can put it in the chat.
Okay. Cool. Well, you are doing some great things. I follow a lot of your you know, if you guys are looking for a photographer, my brother is an amazing photographer. He is the one, guys, that makes candy. He's a man of many talents. God uses him in so many different ways. And so what are some of the things that you have coming down the pike?
Thank you, man. She just put it in the chat. Okay. So I just shoot, and just try to follow Gordon Parks, who's one of my, Gordon Parks was the photographer that captured a lot of the civil rights. Anything you see of Dr. King, the March on Washington, Malcolm X, there was Gordon Parks. He said, my weapon, my choice of weapon is my camera. So that's my choice of weapon. So there's a lot of election stuff coming up. So you will probably see images of that on my page. Cleveland underscore Nelson underscore. That's, you can follow me on Instagram. Other than that, just with the youth at our church, we just have some things coming up this summer and just looking forward to that.
Amen, amen. I see our sister Kim said he takes amazing pics and makes the best candy ever. God bless you, Kim.
Thank you, Kim.
Before we go, guys, does anybody have a word of encouragement or something that you would like to say to youth pastor Cleveland Nelson? Christina said, yes, he does. I don't know. It's like every day around this time, these Spanish people out here want to just make all this noise outside. I don't know if you guys can hear it behind me.
No, but if I may, before anyone says anything, I just want to say that therapy, it can help you. Therapy, it can help you. I remember talking to the therapist, and he, you know, just one session, he said, if you don't get a hold of this, I'm gonna have to recommend you to be committed. That's how traumatic things got to be. Mm-hmm. When you notice it affecting your daily life, mm-hmm. you don't want to get up, you don't want to do this, you don't want to do that. That's when you know it's you have to.
Yeah.
And so just want you to know that God is real and God can take away any issue that you're going through, especially in your mind. You know, you can see the ailments. You can, you know, sometimes when someone has cancer, you may see them lose a hair or, you know, because of the treatments, or someone has a cane, you can't see the inside of your head. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, mental health is something that a lot of us overlook because we can't necessarily see it. You see people smiling and, oh, that person, oh, you're doing so wonderful from what you can see. But on the inside, you know, people are struggling and battling. And guess what? It's not just about being strong or being courageous and all of these different things. Sometimes the courageousness and the strong one is the one who says, I need help.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. I definitely believe that. And I thank you for being able to share that. I know I was talking about, you know, comparing the woman with the issue of blood in it, and what a lot of people may not know that the doctors don't really necessarily tell you. You know, when you're diagnosed with the illness and you just, you know, I'm not talking about, you know, you get something on Sunday and it's over on Wednesday. I'm talking about, you know, years and years of a diagnosis eating at you, and the enemy loves to bombard your thoughts to make you feel like you're getting worse, to make you feel like there's no cure, to constantly remind you that you're going to die from this, to make you feel as though that God is not your healer. And people need to know this, you know. And, you know, I am a firm believer of going to therapy as well as opening up that Bible and to be able to find out what God says about what you're dealing with and learning how to apply the word of God to what you're dealing with, as well as to allow that word to get down into the midst of your heart and to hear you. I'm not saying, you know, God needs help, but what I'm saying is that, you know, when you go to a therapist, you have somebody to physically talk to who can help you to process, to help you to get through some of the day-to-day daily struggles that your pastor may not be able to help you or to direct you, because that may not be his training. You get me? And so although, you know, a pastor may have you know Jesus and everything, but he may not be equipped to be able to point that person to what's needed, or what they need, or the help that they need. So you need both. We need a community of people to be able to pour into us, to be able to help us to get through the daily struggles of life. And so those things are important. Just like we know, just like we always say, going to the doctor is important, but also know what God's word said about it. But you need to be able to go to the doctor and eating healthy and things of that nature. Man, I just want to thank you again for sharing that powerful word today. And this is this Cash App that's up. Guys, Cleve and Keish. Keish is his wife, who she's also youth pastor of the church that they are members of. And, you know, we want to be able to be a blessing, whether it's $5, whether it's $10, whatever you can sow. Let's be a blessing and sow into their lives. Amen. So today is our communion Sunday, and I'm going to, if you guys are on here and you have your communion elements, let's get ready to take our communion. Before we partake, the Bible tells us to examine our hearts, so that we want to be able to ask God for forgiveness in areas where you've missed the mark: strife, unforgiveness, jealousy, envy, hatred, covetousness, fear, worry, unbelief, etc. Also, be sure you are not receiving Holy Communion just as a religious exercise, rather than accepting everything Jesus' sacrifice provided for us. Don't receive it halfway. That will help, or that will keep you from receiving everything provided by Jesus' sacrifice. All of that is found in 1 Corinthians chapter number 11, verse number 30. So the first element that I want us to be able to grab is our bread. And before, while you are grabbing your bread, I want to pray. I want to pray for those, while I have my brother on, if somebody that's on here today and you're dealing with trauma, and you're dealing, and you can identify with this message, and you may know someone. Maybe it's not you. Maybe you know someone that's dealing with trauma. Maybe you know someone that's dealing with mental illness. Maybe it's CTE. Maybe it's dementia. Or I want you to stand in a gap for them today. And I'm going to ask my brother to pray for you and pray for those that are struggling or dealing with mental illnesses and mental health, CTE or whatever, you know, you are dealing with, we want to ask him to pray.
Standing in gap for those unspoken as well. Father God, we thank you for this time. Thank you for everything that you have done for us, Lord God. Lord God, you are worthy to be praised. We worship you. We praise you. You are awesome. You are all that. You are like that. You are everything and some. And Lord God, we thank you because you are so awesome. We thank you because you can be here. You can be in New Jersey. You can be in Philly, Lord God. You can be in Florida. All at the same time, Lord God, you are so awesome and so powerful and so mighty. And we give you all the glory, honor, and praise. And it is right now in the name of Jesus that we ask you to touch, heal, Lord God. Go from heart to heart, Lord God. Mind to mind, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. Lord God, somebody, Lord God, may have been molested, Lord God. And that trauma, Lord God, is in their heart, Lord God. Someone, Lord God, may have seen someone die in front of them, Lord God, and that trauma is haunting them, Lord God. Somebody may, Lord God, may have grew up in a crazy household, Lord God, and something that happened to them in the second grade, Lord God, is still affecting them, Lord God, in their 40s and 50s and 60s. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we are praying today, Lord God, that you could touch, Lord God, that you could heal, Lord God, that you can go, Lord God, to where they are, Lord God, and give them comfort, Lord God, to give them peace, Lord God, to give them everything that they need, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. It's not easy watching family members struggle, Lord God. It's not easy, Lord God, watching people, Lord God, working with young people, Lord God, and knowing that they are the ones who are getting murdered, Lord God, or working with young people and seeing that working with families and their children are being affected by crime, Lord God. It's not easy working with a family members, Lord God, and watching loved one whom could talk to you and have everything that they needed in mind, all of a sudden forgetting things and not being able to remember, Lord God. It's not easy, Lord God. And these things hurt, Lord God. And they're traumatic, Lord God. So I'm asking in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you would touch, Lord God. Someone is pressing, Lord God, like the woman with the issue of blood, Lord God. Someone is pressing, Lord God, reaching, Lord God, for the hem of your garment, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, I pray that you would touch every family, Lord God, under the sound of my voice, Lord God, that you will bring a healing, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Have your way. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Partake of the bread, which symbolizes the physical and spiritual torment Jesus bore to redeem us from all areas of the curse. With this in mind, I want you guys to repeat after me. Lord, it's not right that I suffer from sickness or disease. I judge it now as being from Satan, and I reject it. I refuse to receive it any longer. I partake of the sacrifice of your son's body, and I receive the abundant life that you have provided in Jesus' name. Now let's take the bread and let's eat together. Amen. Partake of the cup and make this confession. Father, I give you thanks for all you have provided for me through the new covenant in Christ Jesus. I partake of those promises now. I am healed now. I am redeemed now. I am the head and not the tail. I am above and not beneath. I take the healing. you sacrificed to give me, and I thank you, and I praise you for it in Jesus' name. Now let's take the cup, which represents the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us commune together. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you all. And before we go, I want to just highlight some of the announcements that we have that's going on this week. On this Tuesday, remember, there is no Christina Nelson show. On Wednesday, for our healing Bible study, we will have, I'm going to be continuing the teaching from Proverbs chapter 4, verses 20. On last Wednesday, I talked about paying attention. And on this this Wednesday, we will follow up with part two. We are preparing for our 30-day Restoring Health Challenge, which is in July. It starts July the 1st through the 30th. And so to join our challenge, we understand that I can't restore you, I can't heal you. God is the one that does the healing and the restoring. And so there are a set of instructions that the Lord gave us to follow, and we're going to follow those instructions from day one to day 30. And next Sunday, we will continue our Men's Health Month. I'll be ministering on next Sunday at 2 p.m. And but one thing I wanted to invite you guys to, everyone that's on. And so there are people who have been diagnosed with illnesses that may not have an opportunity to be able to go out. Many of you may not know, currently I am bedridden, so I definitely understand what it feels like not to be able to go out and spend time with your family and friends or your kids or your dog or whatever. And so God has really shown Pastor Christine and I the true meaning of staycation. And so we wanted to bring a staycation to you guys with a family fun night. And so our destination is in Vegas. I don't know if you guys have ever been to Vegas. There are more things to do in Vegas than just a gamble. So there are a lot of good eats, a lot of good things to do that's in Vegas. And so what we're going to do is we're going to bring Vegas to you. So we want to invite you and Keish and Kim and my mom and everybody who was on. We want to invite you guys out to be able to just a night of fun, man. A night of laughter, a night of fellowship, where you can win prizes and gifts and things of that nature. We're not going to tell you what some of the gifts are. We have some amazing things that Pastor Christina came up with. And so we're looking forward to July the 13th, and we wanted to invite everybody out on that night. So that's all I have for today. Pastor Christine, is there anything?
No.
All right. So we're going to go ahead and close out in prayer. And let us pray. Father, we just thank you for what our ears have heard and what our eyes have seen. We thank you today for this powerful word that was shared today through this chosen vessel, Youth Pastor Cleveland Nelson III. Now, God, we just thank you for him. We thank you for his children. We thank you, Lord, for his wife. And we ask that you would continue to bless them physically, bless them mentally, bless them spiritually, bless them financially. Lord God, we just ask right now that you, Lord Jesus, would have your divine way. Father, we love you. We honor you. We bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
All righty.
Amen. Guys, have a wonderful week. God bless.
God bless.